Hi wizards, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome and make yourself feel at home. Today I'll be showing you how to fix a baggy crotch on jeans. I have these jeans, I love them, but they give me that look that makes me look like I've got junk in the wrong trunk, and I'm not here for that. And this is them after my DIY. So I'm going to be showing you how to fix that messy, baggy, bulky crotch and have a flat laying crotch that looks nice and decent. And without any further ado, let's get right into it. First things first, we're going to unpick the waistband. I know it's cumbersome, it's a lot of work, but someone has to do it. It is quite easy actually to unpick the waistband of a pair of jeans. You're just going to go on the inside, seam rip off a few stitches, and once that's done, the thread comes right off. She just lets go of all her trauma, she's ready to be a new person, and that's what you want. So this is super simple to do, just unpick the thread until most of it comes right off. So you will get two bits where the thread decides to cling on more to her past self. And for these bits, you're just going to go in with your seam ripper and rip those pieces of thread apart. And after some tugging and pulling, she will let go of the waistband and you're good to go. Also, make sure you unpick the belt loop because we need her out of the way so that we can work on the jeans without any interruptions. Once the belt loop has been convinced to let go of her traumas and go into therapy, we're now ready to work on the jeans. I'll be lowering the rise of the jeans by an inch today. So from the top, I'm marking an inch and this will be your mark. I do wish I'd taken in a bit more fabric. So if the rise on your jeans is too high, maybe do 2 inches. So what we're going to do next, there's no formula. We're just going to be freestyling and having a good time. But what I want you to do is avoid the rivets, the metal bits, just avoid them, and draw a half semicircle shape along the top of your jeans. Make sure the bottom slopes are where that 1 inch mark is, and avoid the rivets and go up on the other side, and make sure your lines are meeting where you seam rips the ends of your waistband. So I know this looks complicated, but I promise you it's going to be super easy once you're doing it. And now it's time to shorten the zipper. So what we're going to do is we're going to make sure that 1 inch mark is clear, but we're going to go down by half an inch. And the reason we do this is because we don't want the zipper teeth being caught in our sewing machine. That is not good. It is not good at all. So go down half an inch just to account for your zipper teeth not getting caught in your sewing machine. Mark those points on both sides, and that is where you're going to shorten your zipper too. So how do we shorten the zipper? We're going to go down 2 teeth from our half inch mark. Yes, I know it's complicated, but just stay with me here. Watch what I'm doing. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut off all the teeth above those 2 teeth below the half inch mark. Do you get me? I hope you do. If not, you can watch this in slow motion. I promise you it's super simple. When you're zipping this up, be careful not to have your zipper fly off because that's quite difficult to put back, so don't do that. But I did the same thing on the other side. At the half inch mark, I went down 2 teeth and got rid of all those teeth up until where the zipper zipped. So what we've done now is we've made sure if we attach a waistband, there's no zipper teeth getting caught anywhere. So now we're going to cut off the semicircle shape. I did do one side off camera, and now I'm doing the other side, and you're just going to cut along the line you drew, avoid the rivets. This is going to be so difficult when you get to the point of the pocket because it is bulky fabric. But it's very doable, and once the fabric is gone, pin the pockets in place. And once they're pinned in place, just sew a straight stitch along the pinned area just to make sure they stay in their place. They do tend to shift about if you don't sew them down. So now I'm going to mark half an inch from the top. I know there's a lot of markings going on today, but bear with me. This half inch mark is to guide you when reattaching your waistband. You want to reattach it beautifully so that no one knows you've been in there working your magic. Even if they do, it's no big deal. But we want this to look kind of professional. So I marked half an inch all the way around. I'm obviously going to do this on both sides because the waistband goes on both sides. And for that little pocket thing for me, I got rid of it. I didn't put it back because I had bigger fish to fry. So now it's time to reattach a waistband, and this is where the conundrum is conundruming, okay? This is not easy because the fabric is going to fight you, but you fight back. So those half inch guidelines we drew, just tuck in the fabric until that point. Make sure the waistband is laying on that half inch mark, pin it in place, and that's it. You're going to repeat this for the entire area you seam ripped because you want it to look nice and neat. And now you're going to sew your straight stitch just to wrap things up in a nice little bow. So at the sewing machine, I was fighting for my life. My sewing machine was acting like I asked her what the answer to life was. She was throwing a fit sewing through thick denim fabric. So take your time here, don't get frustrated, just do what you can. You can use denim thread if you have some, just to make sure it matches the previous thread. I just used some orange thread to match the thread on my jeans. And once that was done, it's now time to reattach a belt loop as well. And look at that, I'm showing you the zip is still functional, baby. So the belt loops, we're going to reattach them. And how you reattach them is you lay them down and then push them up a little bit so that they lay against the waistband. Doing this ensures the belt loops are still functional if you do decide to wear a belt. So you're going to sew a straight stitch at the base of your belt loops, and once that's done, you are done with this video. Look at those jeans, they look much better. So I hope you found this video helpful. Let me know if you'll be doing this. I guarantee you it's super simple. Yes, it looks complicated, but I promise you've got this and you can do this. Thank you for watching today's video and see you in the next one. Mwah.